This is an introduction to a new series of vlogs. The general theme will remain the same, life in the village of Bukovlje. But the focus will be more on the nature of the piece of land we have been working for the past 15 or so years. But I will also include video, audio and photographs from my extensive archive of village activities, compiled over the years we have been here. So why the change now? Well, there are three reasons. For some 10 years I've followed the villagers around with my camera, filming their stories and way of life in a series called Scenes from a Village.
On ništa ne priča, on to fino ide kamerom obilazi i snima da niste ni svjesni da vas snima i onda kad vam to kasnije prikaže, stvarno to je filmić, ok.
This series of documentaries stopped after the death of one of my dearest friends, Drago, who featured often in these films. Well, I thought it only fair that I should subject myself to the same treatment and put myself in front of the camera rather than behind. Secondly, in the years that we've been here, I've noticed a widening disconnect between the generations. Most of the very best storytellers in this village have now sadly died. So for me, I consider it important to collect and preserve this knowledge, as it moves out of being a living tradition into the confines of history. And this is what inspired the original Scenes from a Village series of documentary films.
Osim slikanja, ovaj umjetnik bavi se produkcijom kratkih dokumentarnih filmova o ljudima i običajima hrvatskih sela. Andrew skuplja njihove priče, tumačeći ih svoje perspektive doseljenika.
Many of the people that I've gotten to know and make great friendships with, they've died, and that's the real tragedy for me, but a tragedy for Croatian culture, because I don't see anybody else going around recording this culture.
But my third reason, and this is what motivates me now, is that a friend in England discussed on his YouTube channel, The Bald Explorer, his desire to acquire a piece of land and to work at using traditional methods.
And I want to buy a bit of land and I want to get on with it. Before the war, there were all these little farmers and they were producing loads of food. People go, oh, but you can't go back to this. You can't. It's like, we've done this for 12,000 years. And yet, 80 years, we've changed it and it's not been good.
Of all the comments he received, the overwhelming majority expressed scepticism, a number of which were quite dismissive, citing basically too much hard work, or if he wanted just to grow a bit of food to get an allotment. Yes, it is hard work, but to go home physically tired at the end of a good working day is actually very satisfying.
Imamo vrt, ja inače sam iz grada, Andrew isto iz grada i nikad nisam ni sanjala da ću nekada raditi na zemlji. Ali kako je Andrew kao Englez, oni vole vrtlarstvo, onda sam uz njega zaljubila se u to jer volim kad imamo naše povrće koje je ekološko i kad ga uberemo i odmah od njega ručak napravimo, to mi je nešto posebno.
To feel close to the diversity of nature, to work the land and plant trees, provides a spiritual nourishment that comes from no other source. Isn't that right, Zoran?